टुडे लेट्स सॉल्व 2017 ईसेट क्वेश्चन पेपर द सेकेंड पार्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर 26. सो व्हाट इज द क्वेश्चन गिवन. सो व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ लिमिट व्हेन एक्स टेंड्स टू 2 प्लस एक्स इनटू मॉड एक्स माइनस 2 डिवाइड बाय एक्स माइनस 2. सो यू हैव टू रिमेंबर लिमिट एक्स टेंड्स टू ए प्लस. सो लेफ्ट हैंड लिमिट एंड राइट हैंड लिमिट. एफ ऑफ एक्स विल बी लिमिट एच टेंड्स टू 0 एफ ऑफ ए प्लस एच. सो हियर If I consider this h tends to 0, I'll be replacing x by x plus h, which is 2. So 2 plus h into mod of 2 plus h minus 2 divided by 2 plus h minus 2. So this will be limit, nothing but limit h tends to 0, 2 plus h into mod h will be mod h divided by h. So if I simply consider, because mod h, the value of mod x is plus x when x is greater than 0 and minus x when x is less than 0. So let us consider it is going a bit more than 0. So h gets cancelled, and when h tends to 0, we will be left with 2. So this is the important formula, and it tends to a plus. Next. So if a function f of x is equal to 1 plus x whole power 2 of x is continuous at x is equal to 0, then what is the value of f of 0? So you have to remember the formula limit x tends to 0, 1 plus x whole power 1 by x is simply e. Okay? So, but here there is a power of 2. So I can simply write this as limit x tends to 0. 1 plus x whole power 1 by x whole power 2. So this will be 2 by x. So I simply have to square it. So the answer is b square. Now we have to remember some more formulas. So when limit x tends to 0, how exactly we got this value of e? So limit x tends to 0, 1 plus x whole power 1 by x is e. So if I try to substitute the value of x is equal to, simply if I have 1 plus x whole power a by x, it will be e power a. Similarly, when x tends to infinity, so if this x tends to 0, I'll have 1 by x. So x will be replaced by 1 by x. So this will be e. Similarly, limit x tends to a, 1 plus x, 1 plus 1 by x whole power 1 plus a by x whole power x will be e power a. So here I am substituting e as 2. Next, given x is equal to a secant theta, y is equal to b tan theta, what is the value of dy by dx? So y is equal to b tan theta and x is equal to a secant theta. So what is the value of dy by d theta? Will be tan theta is secant square theta. Similarly, what is the value of dx by d theta? This will be a secant theta into tan theta. Now, what is the value of dy by dx? It is nothing but dy by d theta divided by dx by d theta. So, if I substitute b secant square theta divided by a secant theta into tan theta, this will be b by a into secant theta into cot theta. So if I substitute secant theta as 1 by cos theta and cos theta as cos theta by sin theta, these two gets cancelled and we'll be left with b by a into 1 by sin theta, which is cosecant theta. Next, so if x power y is equal to e power y minus x, so x power x is equal to e power x minus y. See, if I apply logarithm on both sides, log of x power x is equal to log of e power x minus y. So this comes to the front. So x power y.
x is y. So y log x is equal to x minus y, because log e base e is equal to 1. So you have e here, so this is log e base e. Now I'll rearrange the terms. Y log x plus y is equal to x, or if I take y common, 1 plus log x is equal to x, or simply y is equal to x divided by 1 plus log x. So what is the value of dy by dx? U by v formula, 1 plus log x into 1 minus x into 1 plus log x, 0 plus 1 by x is the derivative, divided by 1 plus log x whole square. So if I rearrange these terms, I will be getting 1 plus log x minus 0 minus 1 divided by 1 plus log x whole square. So the answer is simply log x divided by 1 plus log x whole square. So you can simply this is not the answer. Next, so y is equal to sine inverse x. Now what is this? So d by dx of sine inverse x, we have a particular formula. So remember, d by dx of sine inverse f of x, this is simply 1 by root over 1 minus f of x whole square into f dash of x. So here it is given, what is sine inverse? So this is your function f of x. So if f of x is equal to x divided by root over 1 plus x square, so what is f dash x? F dash x is nothing but root 1 plus x square into d by dx of x is 1 into x into square root of it. So I can write 1 by 2 into root over 1 plus x square into 2x divided by root 1 plus x square whole square. So this will be simply so if I rearrange the terms, I'll be left with 1 plus x square, because this gets multiplied, minus x square divided by 1 plus x square into root 1 plus x square. So this is f dash x. Now this is the formula. So if I substitute in this, so 1 divided by f of x whole square. So what is f of x by root over 1 plus x square. So I can write x square divided by 1 plus x square. So into this f dash x. So into 1 divided by 1 plus x square into root 1 minus x square. So if I rearrange the terms, I'll be getting divided 1 divided by 1 plus x square. This is an important formula, d by dx of sine inverse x. So the answer is this. Or even I can go with the substitution of x is equal to tan theta. So 1 plus x square is equal to secant square theta. So root over 1 plus x square will be secant theta. So tan theta by secant theta. Tan theta by secant theta. So this is, what is tan theta? Sin theta by cos theta. And secant theta is divided by 1 by cos theta. So this will be simply sin theta. Now sin inverse of sin theta will be simply theta, or I can simply write y is equal to theta. So what is theta here? Theta is equal to tan inverse x. So dy by dx tan inverse x derivative is also 1 plus 1 divided by 1 plus x square. So the next question, what is the slope of normal of a curve x is equal to a secant square theta plus y is equal to
is a tan theta. So if I simply do dy by dx, that is the question which is asked. So first dy by d theta will be a into derivative of tan theta secant square theta. Next dx by d theta is, for secant theta it will be a into secant theta into tan theta. So if I substitute dy by dx will be dy by d theta divided by dx by d theta. So this will be a secant square theta divided by a secant theta into tan theta. So simply it will be cosecant theta. What did he ask? He asked what is the value at theta is equal to. So cosecant of pi by 6. So this is 1 divided by sine 180, sine 30, which is 2. Next, the rate of change of area of a circle with respect to the radius. What is the area of a circle? Pi into r square. He asked rate of change, d by dr of area. So simply 2 pi into r. So what is r? 5. So 2 pi into 5, which is 10 pi square centimeter. Next, which of the following function has a maxima or minima? So if you observe among all this curve, e power x will have a curve like this. So the value keeps on increasing. So even for log x you have an expansion 1 plus x by 2 factorial plus 1. So this is also increasing. Even this, if you substitute x is equal to 1, 2, 3, so on, all these three functions are increasing in nature. But however, if you see this sine x, the highest value is plus 1 and the least value is minus 1. So the maximum value is plus 1 and minimum value is minus 1. So here the answer is sine x. If the increase in the side of a square is 2%, then the approximate percentage increase in the area of square. So let us imagine there is a square xy. Now what is the area x into y? So dA by dx will be x into dy by dx plus y. Now dA is simply x dy plus y dx. So I can, if I divide all this with area, so simply dA by A will be, so dy by y plus dx by x. So the, because here I am asked about the increase in area, so delta A by A into 100 will be simply delta y by y into 100 plus delta x by x into 100. So if the increase in the side of the square is 2%, so if the y increases by 2% and x increases by 2%, we will be left with 4% increase in the area. So for the function f of x is equal to log x plus x square plus y square, which of the following is true? Fx, fy, fxx, fyy. Fyy. So what is fx? Fx is simply dou u by, or dou f by dou x. So similarly, what is f xx? It is double derivative dou f, dou square f by dou x square. And what is fy? It is dou f by dou y. What is fyy? Dou square f by dou y square. Now for this function it is given f of x is 2x divided by x square plus y square. So this is the first derivative. D by dx of log x is 1 by x, and for this derivative is x square is 2x. Now if I again do this f dash of fx double derivative, so I can simply write this as fx.
Now, if I calculate f xx, it will be x u by v formula application x square plus y square into 2 minus 2x into 2x derivative of divided by x square plus y square whole square. So fxx simply will be minus 2x square plus 2y square divided by x square plus y square. Now similarly, if I calculate the value of fy, so fy will be simply log 1 by x and 2y divided by x square plus y square. So what is f dash y or f double f yy, which will be x square plus y square into 2 minus 2y into 2y. Okay, 2 here, 2x here, you have 2y, divided by x square plus y square whole square. So this will be 2x square by minus 2y square divided by x square plus x square plus y square whole square. So simply these two are opposite in nature. So fxx plus fyy, if you add, you get 0. So you have to be good in differentiation. Next, integral cosecant power 5 theta into cot theta d theta. So in this, if you observe, just apply cosecant theta is equal to t, or if I do derivative minus cosecant theta into cot theta, into d theta is equal to dt. So if I substitute this here, integral, if I have to write cosecant power 4 theta into cosecant theta into cot theta d theta, sorry, d theta. So this will be your dt and this will be your t power 4. So simply I can write with a minus here. So t power 5 by 5 minus, so t, if I substitute, cosecant power 5 theta divided by 5 minus m. Next, what is the integral of 1 by x square? So if I simply write this, I'll do indefinite integration. So I have to write 1 by x into x minus 1. This, if I rearrange the terms, 1 by x minus 1 by x minus 1. So, or I have to write the smaller term first. So 1 by x minus 1 divided by 1 by x. So x minus minus x plus 1. So I have to make sure I make it into two partial fractions. So integral 1 by x minus 1 dx minus integral 1 by x dx. So limits 2, 3 and 2, 3. So for this, log x minus 1 mod 3 and 2, upper limit and lower limit, log x 3 and 2. So log of 3 minus 2 will be log 2 minus log 1 plus log 3 minus log 2. So here I have a minus, so minus plus, so this will be zero, and I have log 4 or 2 log 2 minus log 3, or simply log 4 minus log 3. Log c minus d can be written as log c by d. So simply the answer is this. Next,
So what exactly is the definition of mod x? Mod x is less x when x is greater than 0, and it is minus x when x is less than 0. So observe these conditions here. So what is it? Its limit is integral a to b mod x by x, mod x by x will be generally, if you observe, let us imagine it is simply x, or in integral x, if it x gets cancelled, you will get 1 dx. So the limit will be simply integral of 1 x, 1 is x with b and a. So I can simply write x power b minus x power a. But if you simply observe this limits, b is greater than 0 and a is less than 0. So if I substitute this, I will be getting b minus of minus a, which is a plus b. So here you have integral x into tan inverse x dx. So we have to apply integral uv dv. So here integral u into v dv is nothing but u into integral v minus integral du minus integral v into u du by dx. Okay, so here it will be tan inverse x into integral x square by 2 minus integral x square divided by 2 into tan inverse x derivative is 1 by 1 plus x square dx. So this will be tan inverse x into x square by 2 minus integral x square divided by this 2 will come, so 1 plus x square. So I can add 1 and subtract 1, so that this will be left with tan inverse x into x square by 2 is equal to minus 1 by 2. If I add plus 1 and minus 1, I will be left with 1 minus 1 by 1 plus x square dx. So this, why am I trying to do this? So that I will get tan inverse x. So I will be left with tan inverse x into x square by 2 minus 1 by 2 into x minus tan inverse x. So now I substitute the limits 1 and 0, 1 and 0. So I will be left with pi by 4 into 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 into 1 minus pi by 4. This is when I substitute 1. If I substitute 0, I will be left with 0 minus 1 by 2 into 0. So this will be pi by 8 minus 1 by 2 plus pi by 4. Or simply I can write 3 pi by 8 minus 1 by 2. So if you observe, only among these two options, I will go with this because there is a mistake in it. So next question is related to limits. So limit n tends to infinity summation r is equal to 1 to n is 1 by n into 1 by n into f of r by n is simply integral 0 to 1 f of x dx. So whenever you have a summation of this form, you can directly convert it into integration. So if you observe in the question, it is given as 1 by n into f of r by n. F of r by n is your e power r by n. So here it is nothing, this I can treat as e power x. So it is nothing but I am integrating 0 to 1 the limits. F of x is e power x into dx. So this is integral e power ex is e power x with limits 1 and 0. The answer is e power 1 minus e power 0, or e minus 1. So integral 0 to pi by 4 secant square 6x. So if we see the power, we get a bit tensed. But remember, I can rearrange it into secant power 4x into secant square x dx. And then I can again write it secant square x whole square into secant square x. So if you remember, I can
rearrange the term, secant square x is 1 plus tan square x into secant square x dx. So now if I keep tan x is equal to t, I'll be left with secant square x dx is equal to dt. So this integral finally converts into 1 plus t square into dt. Now if you observe the limit 0 and 0, tan x, if I substitute x is equal to pi by 4, I'll having the lower limit as 1, upper limit as 1 and the lower limit as 0. Okay, so integral 1 plus t square will be t power 5, okay, power square. So if you open this up, you will be left with 1 plus t power 4 plus 2 t square. So if I do integration of this, I will be left with 1 plus t power 5 by 5 plus 2 t power 3 by 3. So again, if I substitute the values, so I'll be left with 1 plus tan power 5 by 5x by 5 plus 2 tan power 3 by 3. So upper limit is pi by 4 and lower limit is 1. So I'll be left with 1 by 5 plus 2 by 3 plus 1 minus all the zeros. You have everything 0, which is 28 by 15. Next, what is the area bounded by y is equal to log x, x-axis in the straight line? So the area bounded is simply integral 0 to e, because x is equal to, if you, x minus e is 0 means x is equal to e. So this is your upper limit. So y dx, so what is the function here? Y is given as log, so integral 0 to e log x into dx. So the derivative of log x is x into integrate log x minus 1, the limits are e and 0, integration. So e into 1 minus 1 minus 0, so this is 0, so answer is 0. So the volume of the solid generated by rotating in 1 arc of the curve, y is equal to sin 3x. So volume is integral 0 to pi, pi into y square dx. So if I rotate an arch, it will become a circle. So given y is integral 0 to pi, pi into sine square 3x dx. So this is the y value given. So if I substitute, it will be pi by 2. The pi comes out, integral 0 to pi. So sin square 3x can be written as cos 6x by 2, 1 minus cos dx form. So if I rearrange it, I will be getting pi by 2 into x minus sin 6x by 6, limits pi and 0. So what is, observe the question, the volume of the solid generated by rotating one arch. If you rotate an arch, so if this is a line, if you rotate it, you will get circle. That's why I'm taking it as pi r square. So r is in this case y. So pi by 2 into pi minus 0 minus sin 6 pi is 0 and sin 0 is 0. So I'll be left with pi into pi by 2, which is pi square by 2. Next, y is equal to cx minus c square. What is the generic solution? Y is equal to cx minus c square. If I differentiate it with x, I will be left with dy by dx is simply c, or dy by dx is equal to c. Now if I substitute the c in this equation, so I will be getting y is equal to dy by dx into x minus dy by dx whole square. So simply this is your answer. So what is the general solution of this dy by dx plus y by 3 is equal to 0? So this is in the form of dy by dx plus p into y is equal to q. So what is the value of p and what is the value of q? So if you compare, p is equal to 1 by 3 and q is simply 1. So the integrating factor formula is given by e power integral p dx. So here in this case e power
1 by 3 into dx, or simply I can write e power 1 by 3 into x or e power x by 3. So if I multiply this whole equation with this, I will be left with y into if is equal to integral q into if into dx. So this will be solution. So y into e power x by 3 will be simply integral q is 1 and integrating factor is e power x by 3 into dx. Okay, so if I see this, I will be left with 3 into e power x by 3 integration is equal to y x power e power x by 3. So simply I can write so here I'll add the integration constant. So if I divide the whole equation by e power x by 3, I'll be left with y into 3 plus c into 1 dividing by whole the equation of the equation by e power x by 3. So you'll have e power minus x by 3. So if you see the options, only this is the correct option. Not this, not this, not this. So next. So the differential equation corresponding to the family of curves y is equal to a e power bx. So if you differentiate, I will be getting dy by dx is a into b into e power bx. Now if I differentiate it with respect to x, so next if you observe this, this is simply this y. So I can write dy by dx is nothing but b into y. Or I can write b is equal to 1 by y into dy by dx. Now I will try, I can do a derivative of this equation again. So d square y by dx square is simply equal to b into dy by dx. So if I put the value of b in the equation, in this equation I will be left with d square y by dx square is equal to 1 by y into dy by dx into dy by dx, or I simply write 1 by y into dy by dx whole square. Next. So see this x square. So in the question you are asked about the integrating factor. So dy by dx, I have to write it in the form of plus e plus dy by dx plus p into y is equal to q. This is the form to find integrating factor. So I have to rearrange this in this form. So if I do a division of the total equation by dx, I will be left with dy by dx into x plus x cube plus x square y plus 5 plus 1 is equal to 0. So or I simply can write dy by dx and rearrange the terms plus 1 by x into y is 1 by x plus x cube. So here this is my p, and integrating factor is nothing but e power integral p dx. So e power integral 1 by x dx, this will be e power log mod x to e. So e power e will be simply 1. So I will be getting this outside. So x is my integrating factor. So next question. So ax square plus by square. So here you have two constants. So if I do a derivative of this, I will be getting 2ax plus 2b into dy by dx. If I do again derivative, derivative d square by dx. So for this equation, order is 2. And degree is 1. So the second is your answer. So next, what is the general solution? So I simply can write d square minus 4d plus 5 is equal to 0. So if I calculate the root, minus b plus or minus root over b square minus 4ac divided by 2a, it will be 4 plus or minus root 16 minus 20 divided by 2. Or I'm getting complex roots, which is m is equal to 2 plus or minus 8. So for complex roots, the general solution will be y is equal to e power alpha x into c1 cos beta x plus c2 sine beta x. So where alpha, this is alpha and this is beta. So if I simply rearrange e power 2t into c1 into cos t plus c2 into sin t. So the answer is first option. Next, last question of the day. So d square minus y is equal to sin 2x. So y is equal to simply 1 by d square plus 4 minus 2 into 2, 4d into sin 2x. So in particular integral calculation, you substitute d square is equal to minus a square, and here the a value is 2 because it is sin 2x. So I substitute y is equal to 1 divided by d square is minus 4 plus 4 minus 4d into sin 2x. This 2 gets cancelled and I'll be left with minus 1 by 4d into sin 2x. So what is 1 by d? It is nothing but integral. So y is equal to minus 1 by 4 into cos 2x, sin 2x minus cos 2x by 2, or I'll be having cos 2x by 8.